Linda Papadopoulos. Rachel, so you've got two boys and a girl.
Yeah, and they're all teenagers. And I sort of understood where that was coming from.
Mm. What do you think, Linda? I mean, you've got one daughter, don't you?
So as an only child, I do spoon feeds now. She's seven. Look, I do think we did. I think you're right. I think we're socialised into doing it. I think there's a couple of reasons for this. I think as women, we live with many more sort of shoulds and have tos, whether it's about how we should look or how we should behave. And I think we project those onto our girls a lot more. Mm. I also think with boys, we kind of have this idea of, you know, boys will be boys, so we kind of make more allowances, even with adult men. If you kind of look at things, we make many more allowances if they, you know, even when it comes to anything from violence to even to white collar crime. There's this sense that, well, they're men, they'll do that. So I think as a consequence, the way that we behave to them, it very much reflects that as kids.
But do you think we as mothers are conditioning them into being like?
Well, of course. I mean, the best way to kind of ruin someone's confidence is to tell them they can't do something for themselves. So, you know, if you know, whether that's pouring Rice Krispies or saying you can't clean up after yourself, the best way to instill confidence is to say, actually, you have the skills, you know, whether you have a Y chromosome or not, whether you're a girl or a boy.
I mean, here you are. Look, immaculate, if you don't mind me.
Hairbrushed and
No, but you take my
done.
Point, though. You look like radically...
The boys to iron their own shirts, but I was asked, and I remember sort of sitting there with the iron and thinking, there's something wrong here. And I think that's when the sort of, I was treated slightly differently, but that's about the only example I can think of.
And I think that's the worrying thing. I think from a kind of more serious point of view of how we kind of equality. You know, obviously there's differences in boys and girls, but, you know, a girl should never feel that it's her role to do something like that. You know, as a boy should never feel the expectation that, you know, someone should do it for him. And I think this is where mothers need to step back and take a good look at how they're
Well, I did call her on it, but, I mean, I don't think she was asking them to do it.
Getting you talking this morning equally, which is kind of understandable, isn't it, I suppose? So, yes.
Well, I've read with interest a review of your book about your first year as editor of The Labour.
He's a charmer, Rachel, isn't he?
It's nice to meet you.
Thank you.
Nice to see you again, Linda.